America and the world drew a line in the sand. We declared that the aggression against Kuwait would not stand. America and the world have kept their word. Kuwait is liberated. Iraq's army is defeated. Our military objectives are met.
We said that we'd make a measurable difference in this war, and believe me, I think we have.
Oh, the whole thing is up in the air.
No, this is for the My basic job is make sure that all the stores have all the ship store stock in them. And we sell toiletries, and it's just like a basic 7-Eleven.
And I'm Simon Peña. That's my chief up there.
This is my famous wardroom in the West. I'm proud of my people doing a fine job over here.
That's our MS3 Conrad. He's chopping onions for the chili con carne.
And I hope that chili is as good as it looks.
It
nice,
is.
Hot, spicy.
Yes.
Well, if you put a little tomato,
just like bombs.
Oh, I'm wounded. Is there a doctor anywhere?
We'll be right back.
need two more players.
And the wheel of fortune goes round and round.
We had a great Christmas. The guys in the mess decks did us all proud. They worked extraordinarily hard, and we ate well that day. We had the day off, and for the most part enjoyed the opportunity to kick back, which was one of the first ones we've had, open a few presents that we had, and still await the first real mail call of the cruise. That first real mail call of the cruise, with all the letters that you all had written and all the packages and all the Christmas cards, started coming in on the 27th. Today's the 28th, so we've had two real good days of mail calls.
Mail call. Mail call.
Most important thing on the ship.
Getting mail is the big event of the day. It may even be the big event of the week or the month. So.
We feed three times a day, and I guess that's important, but I'm not sure that everybody wouldn't give up two of those three meals a day for a letter from home.
As long as there's fire in the boilers and we're making steam, mail is the only other concern.
That's morale. The letters from home, that's our only contact.
At 0800, we enter into Grande Island, by Grande Island, into Subic Bay Naval Station, and begin a four-day upkeep there from the 29th until the 3rd of January. We'll be underway and on our way to Desert Shield operations from QB Point, Subic Bay. I would anticipate that mid-month in January, we'll be on station in the North Arabian Sea up in the Gulf of Oman. That is fairly predictable. Beyond that point, right now, I don't think I know if there are hostilities. Then all bets are off.
When we steam out of Subic Bay on the 3rd of January towards Desert Shield, I want you to think lean, I want you to think mean, and I want you to be ready that in case anything happens and we're tasked to go in harm's way, that you can do that job that you're so tasked better than anybody else. So that when we arrive in Desert Shield inside the Ark on the 15th of January, we're ready to fight.
This is the one everybody's familiar with, the F-14, Top Gun movie. A lot of that was filmed right here.
Woo! God! Are you okay?
Shut down, it ain't going, it's dead.
Shut down, shut down, shut down, shut down, shut down.
Rangers, a good team, an air wing that's a cohesive unit. We know each other. We know how to work together. And an aircraft carrier with a lethal air wing is a very decisive weapon. We're ready to do the job when called upon.
Air superiority is going to be the key to any battle that's out there. The ability of the Ranger to put our air group into the fray is probably going to be the big thing that will turn the tide.
Liberation of Kuwait has begun.
The next few days will set the course of the world order for decades to come.
War has begun in the Gulf. American led forces, including British, Saudi Arabian, and Kuwaiti fighter bombers, have launched air attacks on Iraq and Kuwait.
At 0130, 17 January, we launched the first strikes into Iraq as the very first part of that Operation Desert Storm.
I got some bombs on target, lasers coming on.
Come back, Kennedy.
Roger, mother is 480 pounds and we're going to let him travel.
Throughout the entire sky, there are flashes of light. Something is definitely underway here.
Close reports from the Allied side suggest that the Iraqi Air Force has been devastated.
Just got to stay down here 200 feet.
Allied air forces began an attack on military targets in Iraq and Kuwait. These attacks continue as I speak. Ground forces are not engaged. This conflict started August 2nd when the dictator of Iraq invaded a small and helpless neighbor. Kuwait, a member of the Arab League and a member of the United Nations, was crushed, its people brutalized. 5 months ago, Saddam Hussein started this cruel war against Kuwait. Tonight, the battle has been joined.
The courage and the professionalism that's been exhibited by all of the people that have been involved in this campaign in the last 36 hours is nothing short of inspirational.
Once we start that, you're going to be, if you think you've been busy so far,
will they be busy?
San Diego, belated happy Valentine's for everybody. We're great over here. We're bombing Iraq every day, every night, 24 hours, with all those cluster bombs and what's that one? Laser guided bombs.
All right. We're all doing fine here.
We're doing quite well. We're all wishing this war would be over. Perhaps it will be very soon.
Today is the 21st of February, 1991. Ranger is about to fly its 100th strike in combat.
I am pleased to announce that at midnight tonight, Eastern Standard Time, exactly 100 hours since ground operations commenced and 6 weeks since the start of Operation Desert Storm, all United States and coalition forces will suspend offensive combat operations.
Let's get out of here.
An hour ago, the president appeared on national TV and announced that a ceasefire was to go into effect at midnight Eastern Standard Time. The aircraft that are launching off the CAT right now are the last strikes that will be flown in this war called Operation Desert Storm.
Aggression is defeated. The war is over.
On behalf of the Admiral and the CAG and myself, to each one of you guys, for the last 6 weeks of absolutely magnificent work, well done.
Shake it, Linda. Contestants for the evening.
All of the things that you've heard about WOG Day have built up in your mind a perception which probably in most cases will not be validated by the actual event.
The idea is not to damage them, however, it is to make them remember it for many years.
The event is meant to be something which is a time-honored tradition. There will be no gross displays. We will not embarrass or humiliate anybody.
To cleanse these
their nasty, slimy little bodies.
We'll do that well.
On the afternoon of the 29th, as the plan presently stands, at approximately 1600, we will put the anchor down off the beach at Padilla Beach and commence our four-day port visit to Padilla Beach.
I caution you, guys. I know you're going to do it. I know you guys are going to go ashore and act like sailors. That's what you are. But don't get wild. You got to stay under control. The old days of the wobbling, crawling, knee-walking sailor roaring around the Orient on Liberty are long gone.
a great privilege for me to come aboard this morning and welcome you not only to Hawaii, but your first stop in the United States on your way home from a very successful cruise. Thanks for a great job.
We're standing on the USS Arizona in Hawaii, our first stop in the United States. I hope you take the pride in what you've accomplished to heart, and when you carry it back, you will all realize what great things you've accomplished.
Like a lot of sailors, nothing in between.
Here's a toast to the boogie, to the boogie. I toast cognac to a brother cut straight like that.
ABE3 Bailey.
San Diego welcomes home more Desert Storm warriors when USS Ranger returned from her 20th Western Pacific deployment. More than 4,300 missions were launched from her flight deck in support of the Allied victory.
Thank you.
ship nosed up to the pier, eyes strained to find faces they hadn't seen in 6 months.
I'm going to take him home and lock the doors and nobody's coming inside.
I'm glad he's back for the wedding. That's what I was concerned about.
Months ago, while this ship and this battle group were conducting combat operations in the Persian Gulf as part of Operation Desert Storm, two men got together on the deck plates of this ship to write a song. That song was written in response to a video that we saw in February called Voices That Care. The entire ship has since gotten together and supported the writing, the directing, the filming, and the singing of this song. That song that you are about to see was written because we're coming home.
Thanks for the yellow ribbons. Thanks for the prayers you prayed. You helped us hold the course and you helped us pray and say. When it was too late in the evening, yet too early in the morning, you kept our eyes and vision. You kept us from the storm.
And we're coming home, returning from the sea. Though some have gone before us, their peace with him will be. And we're coming home, we fought for victory. To join in arms with loved ones, proud and free.
When we fought him, who and where our dead guns said,
the art of mighty naming, every fight needs our plan.
Lead us firm with vision, our people home, our band.
And we're coming home, returning from the sea. Though some have gone before us, their peace with him will be. And we're coming home, for victory, to join in arms with the ones, a people proud and free.
sons and daughters will know the payments made.
The cost of our dear freedom, but with mark and placed on graves.
We died and bled in earnest, in the belief that efforts bear.
Born on the backs of warriors, our lives for peace we share.
When brother warrior or sister, they fell and closed their eyes. Felt our hearts a burning, yet the voice that drew their cry.
And it's the cry of the young children, the breath of love one has.
Because of mothers and fathers,
it's for America. Well,